hour, and this number, if it is in division, addition, subtraction. So we have to apply some rules so we can easily solve every questions. These rules you already discussed in 8th standard. I am just doing revision of this topic. Please see here the rules of the exponents. Okay. The first rule basically, if we have two different number with different power, right? For example, 2 raised to 3 into 2 raised to 5 power. You can see here 2 raised to 3 means 3 different power and 2 raised to 5. In these two number, you can see power are different and base is equal. So it means what we have to do? We are adding this both the power. So 2 raised to 3 plus 5. What is the answer? 2 raised to 8 power. Are you getting this rule? Yes or
Yes, sir.
no? Are you remember this?
Yes, sir.
Now we can see the second rule. If you have two different power, but numbers are in division form. So we have to subtract the power. 2 raised to 5 minus 3, 2 raised to 2 power. Then rule number 3. If we have two number with different base, for example, 2 raised to 3 and 3 raised to 3. You can see here the base are different, power are same. So if we have base different, what we have to do? We are multiplying this two base. So 2 threes are 6 cube. It is third rule. Then fourth rule, and it is most important rule. If you have any number with reciprocal power, for example, 2 raised to 1 by 2 power. So this 2 raised to 1 by 2 power, it means it is square root of 2. I'm giving you one more example for this. 3 raised to 1 by 4 power. So it means fourth root of 3. If we have 5 raised to 1 by 3 power, so we can say that it is cube root of 5. If we have reciprocal power, what we have to do? We are converting into nth root. કેમાં કન્વર્ટ કરવાનું છે આપણે nth રૂટમાં. nth રૂટ મીન્સ અગર 2 પાવર હોય તો સ્ક્વેર રૂટ 3 હોય તો ક્યુબ રૂટ, 4 હોય તો ફોર્થ રૂટ, 5 હોય તો ફિફ્થ રૂટ, લાઈક ધીસ. સો વેન એવર યુ હેવ રેસીપ્રોકલ પાવર, વી આર કન્વર્ટિંગ ધીસ રેસીપ્રોકલ પાવર ઇન્ટુ nth રૂટ. ક્લિયર ઓલ ઓફ યુ ધીસ ફોર રૂલ? યસ ઓર નો?
યસ
એન્ડ લાસ્ટ રૂલ, ઇફ વી હેવ નેગેટિવ પાવર, if we have negative power, we are changing the position of whole the number from numerator to denominator, 1 upon 2 square, right? And if we have 1 upon 3 raised to
Yes.
minus 2 power, then again we are changing the position from denominator to numerator. And you can see the negative sign, it is
Yes.
adjust whenever you change the position of number. Here again, our negative sign, it is adjust
Yes.
whenever you change the position of this number. Clear all of you?
Yes,
Okay, first write down these five rules. The basic five rules for the law of exponents. Then we are starting exercise.
Sir, it can.
Jordan.
Okay. Okay, now you can see the exercise. Question number one. Find 64 raised to 1/2, 32 raised to 1/5, and 125 raised to 1/3 power. The first question, 64 raised to 1/2 power. Second question, 32 raised to 1/5, and the third question, 125 raised to 1/3 power. Okay. Okay. Now you can see in first question, 64 raised to 1/2. Here you can see power are in reciprocal form. So we are applying the nth root rule. So 1/2 means it is square root. So square root of 64, it is 8. So our answer is 8. Clear, all of you?
Yes, sir.
You can see the rule number 4. No, rule number, yes, exactly. Rule number 4. Nth root rule. Whenever you have power in reciprocal, you are taking the nth root of the corresponding power. Here we have 1/2. So we are taking square root, right?
Yes.
Fifth root means we are writing fifth root of 32. And fifth root of 32, it means 2. What is the meaning of fifth root, you know? If you multiply 2 5 times, we get 32. You can count this. 2 2's are 4, 4 2's are 8, 8 2's are 16, and 16 2's are 32. So whenever you multiply 2 5 times, we get 32. It means the fifth root of 32 is 2. Clear, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Then 125 is to 1/3 power. So here we have 1/3 power. It means we have to take cube root. So cube root of 125. And cube root of 125, it is 5. If we multiply 5 3 times, we get 125. 5 5s are 25, and 25 5s are 125. So what is the answer? 5. It is your question, yes. Number 1. Clear, all of you?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, now you can see the second question. Find 9 raised to 3/2, 32 raised to 2/5. And 32 raised to 2/5. Okay, now you can see here we have power 3/2. It is complicated power, complex power. So first we are converting this power into easy form. 9 raised to 3/2 means 3 into 1/2 power. Yes or no? I am separating the 3/2 power because of 3/2 power is complex power. So we are converting this power into simple form. So 3 into 1/2. Are you getting it?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now you can see we know that commutativity property. In commutativity, in multiplication, the answer will be answer we get, it is same. So we are changing, yes, the position with the help of commutativity property from 3 into 1/2 to 1/2 into 3, right? Now 1/2 means if we consider only this portion, 9 raised to 1/2. So 1/2 means square root. So we are taking square root of 9, and we have 3 power. It is as it is. Now we can see root 9 means it is 3 and 3 raised to 3 power. 3 raised to 3 power means 3 into 3 into 3. 3 3s are 9, 3s are 27. So we get 27 as our answer. Clear all of you?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Same question you can see here. 32 raised to 2 by 5. 2 by 5 is a complex power. So we are converting into simple form. 2 into 1 by 5. Again, we are taking 1 by 5 power at the first term. So 32 raised to 1 by 5 power into 2. Right? Now you can see 32 raised to 1 by 5. If you consider this only term, in which 1 by 5 power means we have to take 5th root of 32. And we have 2 power as it is. So root, 5th root of 32, it means 2 and 2 raised to 2 power. So we get 2 square 4 as our answer. Clear all of you? Yes or no?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Now you can see question number 3. 3 and 4. 16 raised to 3 by 4 and 125 raised to minus 1 by 3. 16 raised to 3 by 4 and 125 raised to minus 1 by 3. Okay, 16 raised to 3 by 4 power. 3 by 4 power is complex power. So we are converting this power into simple form. 16 raised to 3 power into 1 by 4. Right? Now you can see we are converting that 1 by 4 power we are taking the first term. Now you know that 16 raised to 1 by 4, it means 4th root of 16. Raised to 3 power. 4th root of 16, it means 2. Whenever you multiply 2 4 times, we get 16. 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8, 8 2s are 16. So what is the answer? 2 raised to 3 power. And 2 raised to 3 power means 2 2s are 4, 2s are 8. So we get the final answer as 8. Clear all of you?
Yes, sir.
And the last question of this question, question number 2. 125 raised to minus 1 by 3 power. Again here, minus 1 by 3 is complex power. So we are converting this power into minus 1 into 1 by 3 power. Now 1 by 3 power we are taking as first term. Right? Now you know that 125 raised to 1 by 3 power, it means the cube root of 125 raised to minus 1 power. And cube root of 125, it is 5. Because of whenever you multiply it 5 3 times, we get 125. So 5 raised to minus 1 power. Now you can see rule, fifth rule, last rule. 5 raised to minus 1 power. We
Hello.
Sir, your voice is not coming.
I think, sir, network problem.
But then it would lag as well. Sir, your voice is not coming.
What happened? सोचिए तो
सर, योर वॉइस इज नॉट कमिंग.
नाउ इट इज क्लियर?
यस सर.
यस सर, क्लियर.
ओके, राइट डाउन पास.
Sir, return.
Okay. Sir, done.
Chalo.
Okay, now you can see question number 3. Simplify 2 raised to 2 by 3 into 2 raised to 1 by 5 power. Two raised to 2 by 3 into 2 raised to 1 by 5 power. Now we can see here we have to apply some rules. First rule, you can see if we have different power and number are in multiplication form, so we are adding this 2 power, right? So 2 raised to 2 by 3 plus 1 by 5 power. But if you want to add this 2 fraction number, first we are taking LCM because of we have no denominator equal. So we are taking cross multiplication. 5 2s are 10 plus 3 1s are 3 divided by 5 3s are 15. Right? Now 2 raised to 10 plus 3, 13 by 15. It is your final answer. Right? Then you can see question number 2. One by 3 raised to 3 power raised to 7 power. 1 by 3 raised to 3 power raised to 7 power. Now, first of all, you can see if we have 1 by 3 raised to 3, 3 raised to 3 terms is in denominator. If you want to take it into numerator, what we have to do? We are changing the sign of the power. You can see the rule number 5. Here you can see the rule number 5. If we have negative sign, then we are converting into denominator. But if we have in denominator term, so we are taking negative sign. So here also we are taking one negative sign. So 3 raised to minus 3 and raised to 7 power as it is. Now you can see this both the powers are in multiplication. 3 raised to minus 3 sevens are minus 21 power. So it is your correct answer. Right? And last two question, third question. 11 raised to 1 by 2 and 11 raised to 1 by 4. 11 raised to 1 by 2 upon 11 raised to 1 by 4 power. Again, you can see if the power are different and number are in division form, what we have to do? We are subtracting this 2 power. 11 raised to 1 by 2 power minus 1 by 4 power. So we have to take LCM. LCM we are taking 4 1s are 4 minus 2 1s are 2 divided by 4 2s are 8. So 11 raised to 2, 4 minus 2, 2 by 8. And 2 by 8, it means we are dividing by 4. 2 1s are 2, 2 4s are 8. 11^4, it is your final answer.
Clear all of you? Use your mic.
Yes.
And last question of this chapter. 7^1/2 and 8^1/2. 7^1/2 into 8^1/2. Now you can see here base are different. So we have to multiply this both the base. 7 × 8^1/2 power. So you know that 7 × 8 = 56. 1/2 power. And 1/2 power, it means we have to take square root. So square root of 56. It is your correct answer. Here your chapter number 1 completed. Please write down question number 3. Phone mic is on. Whose mic is on? Hamza Chauhan, who is this?
Return.
Okay.
No return. Return all of you.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so here your chapter number 1 complete. Now in next lecture we will start chapter number 5. Introduction to Euclid's geometry. Okay. Now tell me if you have any doubt. बता होमवर्क सेंड करो जो